Hello and welcome. My name is Raghavendra Raghunath. I'm a product manager with the HCM analytics team at Oracle. The topic of the hour is learning analytics. I would like to begin my conversation with the recently published data in which it says that a whopping 94% of the employees tend to stay longer in an organization if the organization invested in their career. Learning and development is one such investment which pays rich dividends, not just for the employees, but also for the organizations in the long run. The topic of the hour is learning analytics, but as a precursor to it, I'll start with the learning management system. If you are an organization that has invested in your employees, you must be having a robust learning management system that is rich with courses targeted towards your employee development. Ideally, the objective of every learning program should be to generate the growth of the learners, promote professional and personal development of the learners, thereby enriching the company culture. So in this context, the most obvious question is, why learning analytics? The answer to that is, unless and until you know more about your learners or the content, you cannot foster a healthy learning culture. So in that context, it is very important to understand learners and the content in your organization. That brings us to the most relevant business questions that pop up to any people leader in an organization. Most of the questions around learning would be related to the learners, their enrollments and the courses, etc. So some of the sample questions could be, what percentage of my workforce are active learners? What is the trend of active learners in my organization? What's the total cost of learning in my organization? And very importantly, most people leaders would like to understand what is the outcome of a learning program that is completed by a learner. So these are some of the very important business questions that has to be answered by the learning analytics product. In this context, we have identified a few examples around learning analytics, which helps answer the business questions raised in the prior slide. So some of these functional areas include the learning outcomes, as I said, the outcome of a learning on the learner, the learning enrollments itself, like, you know, what's the trend of enrollments, how, what are the courses to which people are enrolling, etc. Learning ratings, as in after having completed a learning, how has the learner rated the courses? And finally, on the learning investment, what's the total cost incurred by the organizations in their learning programs? So these are some of the areas, functional areas, which helps answer the questions around learning analytics. So with this, I would like to switch to the actual demo of the product, the learning analytics, and try and see some of the data and the data visualization that helps answer these questions. The first in line is the profile outcome. As I mentioned earlier, the most important business question, or the most important question that any people leader would like to understand or answer is, what's the outcome of a learning program? If suppose there is a learning program that is rolled out to their learners, what is the outcome of it? So the learning outcome is measured by an improved profile data of the learners, as in the skills and qualifications. The skills and qualifications that can include things like competencies, languages, licenses and certifications, honors and awards, degrees, etc. So in this chart that we see here, the donut chart, of the 91 learners, of close to 72% of the learners have new competencies. They have acquired new competencies. Close to 20% have acquired new certifications, licenses and certifications, and about 9% of them have improved their existing competencies. It could be an improved rating of their competencies with the learning program. And the next logical question in continuation with this visualization is, if workers have gained new competencies, gained new certifications, or have improved their competencies, what learning items led them to that? So you need to answer the learning items or the learning programs or the learning records that help these learners improve their profile. So the bar chart out here gives you the list of learning items or courses that has helped the learners in enhancing their skills and qualifications. So these are broken down by various courses, and the stack bar out here defines, based on each of these courses, how many workers gain new competencies, new licenses and certifications, or improve their competencies, or acquired new skills, like, you know, or it could be new degree or new acquired new languages or reading, writing skills of particular languages, etc. These are some of the skills and qualifications enhancements that have happened on the learner. So on drill down from here, you could also analyze which is the worker that has had an improved skills and qualifications. In this case, we could look at this course, Emotional Intelligence and Resilience. When I drill down into the details, I find that these are the workers that have either added new competencies or improved their competencies or have added new certifications, etc. So just to summarize, the profile outcome is an extremely important measurable data about the outcome of learning completion. The next in line is the enrollments. I would like to analyze the enrollments of learners into various courses. The enrollments are the voluntary enrollments are by the learners, and in this scenario, what I would like to understand is, like, you know, what are the popular courses by enrollments, popular courses by completion rates, and popular courses by ratings. In an ideal world, in an ideal scenario, the learning items or the courses that have the maximum enrollments are the ones that have high completion rates or the maximum completion rates, and the ones with the maximum completion rates could be the ones that have high ratings. These are all interlinked in an ideal scenario. But it can so happen that not always the most popular courses by enrollments can be completed on time. It could, a lot of factors can come in play here. So you could analyze the popular courses by various factors like enrollments, by completion rates, and by ratings, which can be, sometimes can be, it could be an intersection of all these factors, or in some cases it could be mutually exclusive. And you would also want to analyze the courses that have enrollments but zero completions. Time for you to check if this learning course or item has to be in the learning catalog in the organization for future learners. Or do you have to sunset these courses that have takers but people are not interested in completing them? And similarly, based on these enrollments and completions, you could also look at how satisfied are your learners. The satisfaction levels of the learners can be analyzed by various data points. One of the data points that I've used here is by age bands. I get to understand that people in certain age band, like, you know, less than 25 years, are the group that are not very happy with the learning course. So what could be the reason? Do I need to make amends to the existing course or provide them new set of courses for their consumption? This bar graph out here, satisfaction learners by age bands, gives me the information about the satisfactory levels of learners by age bands. And one of the examples out here I have is the comparison between teams, as in there could be managers, and the comparison between teams by the managers, by the top level managers. So in each of the managers, in a number of learners in their teams, and the average learning items per learner in the respective teams, and the completion percentages in the teams, and the average cost per learner. This could give me an idea as to which are the teams or which are the managers that are promoting maximum learning or encouraging learning in their organizations. This could also be analyzed by countries, locations, or business units, etc. These were about the popularity of the enrollments and the completion and non-completion of learning enrollments. In some of the similar examples, I would also want to talk about how the performance and potential ratings of the workers are influenced by this learning. Over here, there is a huge number of learners that have improved their performance rating and potential performance rating, especially after having completed certain courses or learning items. So in this case, I could see a big number which is on the high scale of the performance, and the learners, there are also a couple of few learners that have improved their performance and potential rating to the level to the high level after having completed the specific course or set of courses. You could also analyze the trend of learners in your organization, and overall, what is the average cost per learner in the organization? And in all the catalog, in the learning catalog that is available, which are the top rated courses? And overall, in the org level, what is the completion rate, etc.? An aspect that I would want to talk about here is in the top rated courses, you could also analyze the ratings of the courses by overall course rating versus the course that are rated by different regions, locations, age band, tenure band, and by people in various jobs, etc. So there could be a course which has got a universal rating of maybe 4.5 out of 5, but in various countries, it can be rated differently. It could be 3.5 in India, it could be 4.2 in US, etc. So you also have these. You would want to understand why a particular course is very popular in a few countries but not so popular in a few other countries. So you could also this dimension of analyzing the course material by ratings is also available in the learning analytics module. So these are some of the examples that I wanted to share in today's session. These are only the tip of the iceberg. There are many more possibilities that you can do using this newly rolled out learning analytics product. I would encourage all of you to engage more and more to understand the true potential of this learning analytics capabilities. Happy learning. Thank you.